Hello everyone, do you still remember Wan Animate? That is right. The amazing character replacement model, the official ComfyUI team now provides native support for this model. As we can see, the official team released a blog post where you can download the corresponding workflow. Previously, we tested this model using ComfyUI's extension, and the results were quite good. However, we also encountered some noticeable issues, such as color casting. So, will the official ComfyUI version be any better? Let's find out together. This video's test will be more in-depth. We will conduct a comprehensive test of the native ComfyUI workflow in 5 parts. These 5 parts include, first, a traditional video of singing and walking, second, a clip from a sci-fi movie, third, an animated fight scene that contains a special camera angle, fourth, a live-action boxing video, and fifth, a video with a unique occlusion. I've also made some optimizations to the workflow to allow it to automatically extend videos. This is a very convenient feature for videos that are longer than 5 seconds. I have built all the workflows on Running Hub, which you can access through their platform, in the ComfyUI space. Running Hub is an excellent online workbench because it updates immediately whenever a new extension is released. You can register on Running Hub using the invitation link in my video description to receive 1,000 free credits. Additionally, you get 100 points for logging in daily, which allows you to try out your own workflows. Now, let's take a look at this workflow. It is slightly different from the official one you can download because I've restructured it a bit. The purpose of this restructuring was twofold. One, to make its structure clearer, and two, to add the automatic video extension feature. The video extension capability is also present in the official workflow, but it isn't automatic. This workflow has 2 very significant characteristics. First, it heavily borrows from ComfyUI's workflow, even using some of ComfyUI's models. Second, its approach to face and post-processing is fundamentally different from ComfyUI's method. Regarding the configuration, I've mainly set the resolution and the number of video frames to be processed in each sampling batch, which I've set to 77 frames. For the main model, please note that it loads ComfyUI's FP8 model. The official release doesn't provide an FP8 model, only an FP16 version. You can download the official model from this address, but be aware that it is quite large, nearly 34 gigabytes. So, if you want it to run faster, you can use ComfyUI's FP8 model. I've also added a relight LoRa. Note that ComfyUI has slightly restructured the directory, so the download address for this LoRa has changed a bit. Following that are our dual encoders, visual encoder and our VAE. My prompt is quite simple, a character playing guitar and singing. Then we have the input video. Pay attention here, I've forced the frame rate to 16. Also, you must ensure the resolution both width and height is a multiple of 16. This is a limitation inherent to the Wan Animate model itself. Next, we can use the video info node to get the original frame rate and total frame count and save the original images and audio. Here's the replacement image. There aren't strict requirements for this image's resolution. It can be square, widescreen, or vertical. Then, we encode this image using our video encoder. Moving on to the video processing section. First, we scale the original video to match our set resolution. Then, we extract the poses. Note that we are extracting 2 sets of poses, one for the body and one for the face. This is different from ComfyUI's method, which crops out the face and doesn't really use poses in the same way. In the native workflow, both use DW Open Pose 1, focuses on the body pose, the other on the facial pose. It is crucial that when you select these models, you choose the TorScripts version. Otherwise, this node will run very slowly. After that, we need to isolate the character from the background. Here we use the Point Editor node. Green points represent what we want to select, and red points represent what we want to exclude. You don't need many points in principle. Then, using the SAM segmentation, we can extract the corresponding mask. After extracting the mask, we expand it by 10 pixels and then blockify it, a technique we also used in the ComfyUI workflow. This is the blockified mask. We then use this mask to paint a black area onto the image. So, as you can see, we have 2 reference inputs. One is the mask video and the other is our background. Next, we come to a very important node here, Wan Animate to Video. Pay close attention to this output called Video Frame Offset. This output represents the starting frame number of the current batch relative to the entire video. This is what enables the video extension feature, which we'll discuss how to use in a moment. Then it goes into our sampler, a very traditional sampling process. After sampling, we remove the first few frames. How many frames to remove is calculated by this node here. We all know the first few frames are usually not usable, so they need to be removed. Okay, let's look at the original video.
If you miss the train I'm on, you will know that I am gone.
Now let's look at the replaced video.
If you miss the train I'm on,
you might have noticed that the facial expression transfer and character replacement are done quite well. However, the lip sync doesn't seem very accurate. This is because the lips occupy a very small number of pixels, making them difficult to detect properly. You'll also notice another problem. It hasn't replaced the entire video. That is because we only process 77 frames here. Why? On one hand, it is a matter of computing power. If you want to replace the entire video, you must use the nodes down below. This section is where the automatic extension feature comes in. Here we need to calculate how many times we need to loop for this extension. I take the total number of frames and divide it by the number of frames we process each time, which is currently 77. Then I round it up to the nearest whole number. Since I've already done one initial sampling of the video, I need to subtract 1. For this example, this number comes out to 2, which means I need to go through the extension loop twice to process the entire video. First, we set the total number of loops. This input here is the video generated from our first sampling pass. Notice here, we have a getAFrameFrame offset, which is the output from the node we mentioned earlier. We put it inside the loop because this value will change after each extension. So initial value 1 is our original generated clip, and initial value 2 is the frame offset of the current video segment within the entire timeline. Then we go through another sampling process. This sampling is mostly the same as before, with one key difference right here. Notice we have an additional input called continuum motion. So how do we distinguish between an initial sampling and an extension sampling? It depends on whether value is passed into this input. I am passing initial value 1, which is the video from the first sampling pass. This tells the sampler that the current operation is an extension based on the first pass. After this sampling is complete, it will once again generate a new video frame offset. That is why this value needs to be updated, and why it must be inside a loop. After sampling, I again remove the necessary initial frames, decode them, and then combine the newly sampled video with the previous one to form a longer, complete video. This combined video then updates our initial value 1, and we go into the loop again. The video frame offset also updates initial value 2. This way, value 2 also changes. After 2 loops, we get the complete video. Okay, let's see the result.
If you miss the train I'm on, you will know that I am gone.
What do you think? This result is better than Kijai's version, at least in terms of color. Now, let's look at another common type of video. Here is the original video. And this is what we want to replace it with. After sampling, let's see the final result. Take note, the video quality does seem to degrade slightly the further into the extension we go. So, I'd recommend not using this method for extremely long videos. However, there is indeed no color casting issue, and the motion transfer is excellent. Alright, next let's look at a more complex example. The original video shows a woman in a spaceship, and there is a monster outside attacking the glass. It has a very cinematic sci-fi feel. Let's watch. Now let's see the final result after replacement. Look at that motion transfer. It is really done incredibly well. You might notice that in the last few frames, the video seems to loop or freeze. This is because I sample 77 frames each time, but the very last batch might not contain a full 77 frames, which causes this issue. You can fix this by taking the final generated video and trimming it to match the total frame count of the original video. This will remove the looped part. Now, let's look at this next example, which is very illustrative. Here is the original video. Notice that this looks like a game scene, and the camera angle is not level. It is more of a high angle or top-down view. What effect will this have? Let's look at the final result. See, the initial pose looks a bit strange. Doesn't it seem like his legs are short, as if he is squatting? So you'll find that when the camera angle isn't level, the pose transfer can have some problems. Here is another fight video. It is two boxers. It really has that punch-for-punch feeling. This camera angle is much more level. Okay, let's see the result after replacement. Including the final close-up shot of the girl's face. It makes you think she is harmless, but you wouldn't expect her to pack such a powerful punch. Finally, let's look at a very unique video. An old man is sitting, and an incandescent light bulb is circling around him. This causes significant changes in the lighting and shadows. The purpose of this test isn't about motion, but about the overall effect. Let's see the final generated result. First, note that the character transfer itself is fine. However, the rotation of the light bulb is a bit problematic. Also, notice that the lighting and shadows are not rendered very well. Therefore, when using Wan Animate, you shouldn't expect it to be able to replace lighting and shadows. It can't do that at this time. Through all these examples, I believe everyone now has a much deeper understanding of Wan Animate. Overall, I feel that the official ComfyUI version does offer a quality improvement over Kijai's version. So what are you waiting for? Go ahead and try it for yourself. Follow me to become an AI expert.